take you back quite a bit. How was your dating journey? How long did you date? How was it?
It's like we dated for less than a year. Actually, it was 6 months. Because we started talking much in 2011, December. And by 2012, March, alikuwa ameenda kwetu. Introduction. And Rorashio, I think it was May. Our wedding was in September. So it's like less 6 months, less than 1 year. Yeah.
Well, I want to say that because I want to be sincere. Much of why we have young relationship breaking up even before they start is because one of the mistakes people do is that they take too long thinking that they are knowing each other. What exactly are you running up and knowing about each other? You have a whole life to know each other, and let me assure you, even some of these couples you see at their deathbed, they have not even known each other. So this concept and the two mistakes that young people will do is not knowing the distinguishing between dating and courtship. Because now, I would stand it. I courted her for around 6 months. We never had the luxury of so many months for dating. Dating is what you call taking people for a cup of tea. And let me be open here, because we are talking about relationship. You can date as many people as you'd want. Because dating, it's all about looking for someone who is compatible with you. So Esther, if today I take you for a cup of tea, and tomorrow I take another lady for coffee, I'm dating. Now, the biggest problem today in our generation is when I take you for that cup of coffee, you definitely want to stick like super glue together. You have not even known anything. You don't even know what will happen in between. Siarini pereka kahawa. Bas. Mimi niko na mtu. Yet that is not courtship. So I think the basis of every relationship is when young people understand, when do I start courting? Because when it is courtship, it has goals. It has objectives. Si kwenda tu kutumia pesa ya mtu. That's why we tunakuta tuko na hii mashida. Because somebody wants to do something because anashindwa. You know, you can't have spent a whole weekend with me and spent my money. And you are telling me ati sijui bado unifeel. Okay, utaanza kuniambia aje unifeel. Na umekula baka fea. Ulitumio baka fea ya kukuja. So when the young people will understand the difference between dating and courtship and the seriousness that involves there in between. Because let me just say, we are in a season where kuna hii kipindi munaangaliana whether you are faithful or not, especially in campus, yeah? You reckon, now that is in the, ndio imeruka sana kwa social media. And I'm asking myself, you are gauging your faithfulness to who is not even entitled to you. Just because you smile to each other, you take tea at the canteen together, you go out for chips and chicken, now you want even to ask for their phone and check. Sometimes that will not work because you're also insecure. You are very much insecure. When you make those decisions, it becomes much more easier because in courtship, you are sure. I know this person, or we have an objective towards a particular thing. So I'm not saying dating is bad, but we need to know when to stop dating and start courting. We need to know when to progress to the next levels. Yes.
Okay. So did you encounter any cultural differences during when you went to see each other's families? Were there any cultural differences? Were you accepted? The other person's family?
Other than the aspect of... let me be very sincere. I got married, I think. We got married at that time where people from Nyeri were really doing things to each other. It was, and of course, you'll go home and you're saying you are taking people to Karatina. You ask, are you sure? Are you sure that is where you want to go? But I usually say that cultural differences should not be a barrier for people to love each other. Should not. And basically, the major thing that you need to know is that when you are accepting to be involved in that different culture, do you understand anything about them? You know, I would urge young people, don't be blind to what the culture of the person you are loving says, because it will have an effect. We did it because we come from Mount Kenya region. And basically, there is similarities in a lot of things. But if you are to do that as a young person, you need to understand a few aspects, concept, you know, of the culture you are engaging in. Don't just love because you met in Nairobi or in another big town. Just understand to know how are people treated. What is the language of acceptance? By the way, yes, there was one. Let me remind you that we usually say in part of the central region, we usually say jambo in a very common way, we mwega. And you will return it casually, de mwega. You know, I go to Nyeri and I'm greeted. How do you say? Wakiawa. And you know, you have to know that before you go. You cannot just be greeted by your in-laws, wakiawa, and then you say nekuega. It doesn't work. They expect you to have already known wakiamaitu. Yeah, languages various. You need to understand the normal greetings ways, because the moment you are greeted and you cannot even answer, then it means you have no interest in the culture where you're getting married. So we had small, but being who I am, I was wise enough.
Nilicheza kama
mimi vibaya sana.
Okay, that's nice to know. How was the proposal?
Hey, mambo Esther. Well, akuwa ngumu. Just before she says it, maybe a caution to the young people today. Yeah? We put more emphasis on the proposals than even, not even the wedding. Even we don't think about the marriage. Yeah? I've heard stories. I know some would disagree with me on the same. But I usually say, be conscious, because, well, so how was it?
About engagement, it didn't bother me a lot, because my age was, I was not young, okay, I was not young, I was not old, I was 20s. So ni ile, unataka pia wewe kuanza life ya marriage, uanze kwako. So it came a time, aliniambia tu, we go for a coffee, and we had a cake, a small cake, and hapo ndio engagement ring ilikuwa. I didn't take a, yeah, sikuwa nime expect, but I'll have to kukata, mimi nilikata, nikaona that ring, and akaniambia I want to start life with you. Yeah, and that was my engagement.
Okay.
Make it simple, make it fun.
Uh-huh.
Don't go beyond your means, because again, what will happen after that? Of course, aneza akali arafu akwambia I'm sorry. So you also need to have some sort of shop as for the the boy child, yeah? Umeita kila mtu arafu anasema sikukuwa serious na ikitu. So you also need to know at what particular point do you propose, yeah? And of course, as young as we are, also be careful. Don't just propose to every single person you meet for a relationship in a month, you are kneeling down. and you have never knelt down before God, hello, you need to understand these things. It will cause you some dangers in life. First of all, kneel before God and then go kneeling before people. Yes. But the major part of the fun, eh? Ni ile sijui kama muliamua ni culture. Ile lazima mfunikwe. Alafu utafute mtu hapo ndani. So sometimes I wonder ukimeka mistake usahau kuchagua wako. Hapo sasa noma inatokea, eh?